Hello, Folk Alliance International. Welcome to my second showcase. I'm here with Cathi Olivieri, viola player extraordinaire tonight. We're going to open with Leaving Me Dry. Okay, everyone, so when this streams, I'll be sitting online, so if you want to ask questions or anything, please do. I spent the last 12 years in Santa Barbara, California, and that song, Leaving Me Dry, I recorded with the wonderful Kenny Edwards playing guitar. He used to play with Linda Ronstadt. This evening, we're coming to you from the beautiful Fremantle Church, which is on the west coast of Australia, so we have those absolutely adorable sunsets. What else can we tell people about Fremantle? It's a gorgeous, beautiful place. We have a little harbour. We have fantastic food, lots of Italians and Croatians and so many different ethnicities here. It's a very rich place. Lots of artists and musicians reside here as well. So I think maybe that's how we ended up here. This next song's called Reasons. It's on my new album, You Wanted to Be the Shore, But Instead You Were the Sea. And I realised I need some water before I sing this song. This goes out to all the mamas who've lost babies. This is for you. Heaven need another angel? Does time really heal our pain? Does everything happen for a reason? Maybe we make the reasons to ease the pain. And is everything meant to be? Tell me, is my baby in heaven? How can we believe in a God that would take such a delicate life? Who says we're never given more than we can handle? 'Cause I've been given too much, far too many times, far too many times. I'm beginning to understand, we can't forget or get over it, but we find a new way to carry these things inside. 'Cause we're all broken little pieces of pottery, repaired with gold, gust and glue, to let in. I always thoroughly enjoy playing with Cathi. And Cathi and I met over 20 years ago, probably more like 25 years ago, 28 years ago. And she played on a release I did when I played in a duo called Flavour of the Month. We were kind of doing this Gillian Welch, David Rawlins thing, busting out, breaking new ground in Australia, and Cathi arranged the strings and played on it and was really instrumental in making that recording sound so beautiful. But you have to come to one of my live shows to grab a copy of that because it's not online. However, this song is, it's called No Longer Mine. And it's on the new album, You Wanted to Be the Shore, but instead you were the sea.
But you're not that kind of guy.
I thought you loved me thin. I thought you loved me thin.
But you're not that kind of guy.
Lovely, because when this streams, I will be there to engage in the chat, which will be wonderful. Oh, so when Flavor of the Month, the duo disbanded, I started out as a solo artist, and my first solo release was called After the Flood. I wonder if they picked that up. There's like a car hooning down the street, doing burnouts as happens in every. Every great little town. Yeah, so anyway, this is called After the Flood. Hope you enjoy it. 1, 2, 3.
you go.
We had a lovely audience here. We just got out of a little short COVID lockdown in Western Australia a week ago, and we are very blessed. We've had very few cases because we are so far away from everything here compared to my life in America and California when we were near everything. And so we just got out of a COVID lockdown, but I do send love and care to all my family and friends in America who are dealing with COVID and the after effects. And here's thanks to science and vaccines coming on the way. America's in the middle of winter. Well, we're at the tail end of our summer right now, so we're sweating here. It's nice and warm and toasty. I'm going to play you Slow Burn. Might want to get it right though.
Just like snow now, slips through my fingers like something I've never seen. Forgive me for leaving your life in a mess because of me. Feel like broken glass now, tiny pieces put together might equal me. Can you ever forgive me? 'Cause it takes time. It takes time. Me rolling cigarettes, nappies on the line. Years like our regrets, baby's footsteps in time. Me rolling cigarettes, nappies on the line.
Thank you so much. I didn't bring a copy of my new album with me to show you, but its US release is March 26th. It's called You Wanted to Be the Shore, But Instead You Were the Sea. My name is Natalie D-Napoleon, N-A-P-O-L-E-O-N. This is Cathi Olivieri. And, oh wow, did you play on this recording? No, I just, oh you did. Okay, cool. So yeah, this is off my solo EP, After the Flood. And it was inspired, this song, I'm a poet as well, so sometimes now I confuse my songs and poems. This song is called How Seamless Seemed Love, and it was inspired by a line from the wonderful Persian Iranian poet Hafez. And his line was, how seamless seemed love, then came trouble. And it was just way too good, so I stole it. Thank you, Hafez. 2, 3, 4. Oh no, it's not 2, 3, 4, it's a waltz. 1, 2, 3. So if you want to waltz to this, please do. Thank you.
want you to need me. I needed you to warm me. And how seamless seemed love, then came trouble. Then came trouble.
Maybe live. So yeah, I think Cathy may have played on the first live thing. I think on the recording it's just me and Ian Simpson playing pedal steel. It's very beautiful and haunting.
We practiced it. We were all singing.
Oh, yeah. Trouble!
That's always fun.
So I'm a poet as well. I have a book out called First Blood, which is about my girlhood growing up on a farm. I'm really a first generation Australian, and I'm a first generation American too, would you believe that? My parents were farm workers and they ran a farm and grew fruit and vegetables, and I wrote a book based around my stories and my girlhood growing up on a farm, because I thought that may become a forgotten childhood. And of course, being a poet, I decided when I worked on this new album, which I sat on the front porch of our 100-year-old cottage in Santa Barbara. It was my little refuge because our house was so tiny. And I sat on the front porch and the cat would hang out with me. And we lived in the Latino barrio, so people would be walking by, going to the local market, buying their beans and meat and tortillas. And sometimes people would stop with their kids and listen to me playing, and sometimes guys would be like, what guitar is that? And, you know, people would just kind of, they'd stop and they'd go, huh? You know, so I really like that. I like how music kind of wakes people up. That's why I continue to do it. Anyway, this title track of the album is called, very poetically, You Wanted to Be the Shore, But Instead You Were the Sea.
How could I have ever known that the house I lived in was not a home? When I was a child, I wanted to believe you were the shore, but instead you were the was broken in the storm. I was so far west I couldn't see the sun arising in the east. It was not my fault, it's not my fault. I say it again. I remember it's not my fault. If I was the sun, you were the black cloud, the cumulus gathering inside my mouth. If I was the sun, you were the murder of crows, like rain coming down. to believe you were the shore, but instead you were the sea.
See, now you get to hear all the stage banter that happens normally that the audience can't pick up. Oh, it was nice to do that. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah, so this is also, if you're streaming in the public, please do click on the link that is to raise money, and I will share that link in the live stream when our recorded live performance is live streamed. Yeah, there's a link to donate money to musicians and artists and help support them in these difficult times. It's a really nice thing that Folk Alliance is doing, because normally you have to pay for a ticket to go to Folk Alliance and you know, just think about it, even if you can spare a couple of bucks or $5, the music industry has just been hit so hard by what's happened, and I have so many friends out of work. And you know, even in little old Western Australia, I had to cancel a gig a week ago because of COVID, so I'm going to need some water. So what do women do when they break up with someone? We cut our hair, we dye our hair, we change our hairstyles. It's kind of just symbolic. Go shopping. It's just symbolic of starting over again. This song's called Cut Your Hair. When your heart gets broken, cut your hair. You on the street, he will never know.
you once loved him.
Let's cut your hair. Oh, I think we're going to play Broken next. How are we doing for time?
What does the clock say? 7:55.
So it's really nice to be back at church. Let's say that again. It's really nice to be back at a church to play you these songs, because we actually recorded the album at a chapel with one mic, with a Roya ribbon mic. And Jim Connolly co-produced and played bass, Dan Phillips played piano. On this next song, he actually played Celesta, and Doug Pettibone from Lucinda Williams and many other wonderful people played guitar on this. This song's called Broken. This was the last song we finished in our recording sessions. We recorded over 2 weekends, and when I finished this song, the last take was the take, and I collapsed to the floor and I said, I got nothing left. So this is called Broken.
Shattered little pieces of pottery.
shining, 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 shining light. What I see is beauty in your vulnerability as the tears roll down your face. Your openness, your brokenness, it brings me to my knees, because what is broken and shattered into tiny little pieces inside you. It is so beautiful, beautiful, so beautiful. It is so beautiful, beautiful, so beautiful. It is so beautiful, beautiful, so beautiful.
Thank you. This song is called Wildflowers, and it was inspired by, in part, by seeing the wildflower super bloom in California. Huge fields of yellow flowers and purple flowers and orange poppies, and I thought, wow, I wonder what it would be like just to lay down in that field of flowers and just die. And it kind of inspired this idea about a timeless love story. I'm wondering if I laid down in that field and died, if two or three seasons later, if the flowers would sprout up around the shape of my body.
Thank you.
I'll just file that away with all my other creepy love songs. It goes in the creepy love song file there for wildflowers. So this is the opening track of the album. It's called Thunder Rumour. I'm really happy with the arrangement we got of this song, and I love Doug Pettibone's growly electric guitar that opens up this track. You're just going to have my soothing acoustic guitar instead, and Cathy's beautiful viola, not violin, viola. So that's a treat, such a treat. We need water. It was about 80 here today in Australia, and we're in this church with the AC turned off so you guys can have this beautiful sound for this live stream.
We suffer.
Yes, we do. We do suffer. I hope you guys understand that. Please give money. Give money to the Musicians Fund. I'm going to put the link up with the stream. This is called Thunder Rumour.
Clothes on the front lawn. Said, babe, I can find any port in the storm. Phone is telling me that you're coming home. And every time it rings, my blood turns cold. My blood turns cold. Heard a thunder rumor, heard a thunder rumor.
Thanks everyone for tuning in to my Folk Alliance International Showcase, the second one. Thank you, Cathi, for joining me this evening. Thank you, Brett, for filming and recording.